Good afternoon, dear students. In the last class, we have discussed about the corrosion. Okay. Now, today, I am going to discuss about the prevention of corrosion. How can we prevent the corrosion? What are the methods is there? Okay. One by one, we have to discuss. In the last class, we have discussed about the corrosion. In that, we did the one more activity. In that activity, we have taken the three test tubes. One of the test tubes we can fill the half with water, and another test tube we can fill with water and 1 ml of oil, and third test tube we can fill with anhydrous calcium chloride. Okay, that anhydrous calcium chloride, what is the use of anhydrous calcium chloride? It will be absorb the moisture from the air. Okay, in the second test tube, what is the use of oil? That oil will be prevent the dissolving the air into the water. And first test tube only water is there, and we can keep the nails in that three test tubes, and you can label the test tubes A, B, C. Which test tube will be corrosion will happen? Only test tube A only will be that nails only corroded. Remaining B and C, it does not corrode. What is the reason? Why? Because there is no air is not dissolved in test tube B and C. That's why only test tube A only corrosion. That nails are corrosion. Okay. Now, up to there we are discussed what are the prevention of corrosion. What are the methods is there? Okay. The rusting of iron can be prevented by, already we know some methods, general methods, painting. In our home also we are observing the, we are painting the gates and any iron articles because of prevention of rusting. Okay, first method is of painting and oiling and greasing and galvanizing. So oiling, greasing and galvanizing and chrome plating, anodizing or making alloys. Okay, one by one we have to discuss. The rusting of iron can be prevented by painting, oiling, greasing, galvanizing, chrome plating, anodizing or making alloys. Okay, what is the galvanization method? What is the galvanization method? Galvanization means, galvanization is a method of protecting steel and iron from rusting by coating them with a thin layer of zinc. Galvanization method is protecting the steel and iron from rusting. How can we protect? By coating with them a thin layer of zinc. We can coat with them a thin layer of zinc. Okay, the galvanized article is protected against rusting even if the zinc coating is broken. If even the zinc coating is broken also, it will be protected from the rusting. Okay, so most of the iron articles and steel articles, we can use this method, galvanization method. What is the galvanization method? In the galvanization method, it is protecting the steel and iron from rusting by coating with them a thin layer of zinc. This is called galvanization method. That galvanized articles are protected against rusting even if the zinc coating is broken. If it is that zinc coating will be broken also, it will be protect. So this is a useful method for steel and iron protecting from rusting. Okay. Next, alloying. What is the alloys? What do you know about alloys? Alloying is a very good method of improving the properties of a metal. Alloy is a very good method of improving the properties of metal. We can get the desired properties by this method. For example, iron is most widely used metal, but it is never used in its pure state. This is because pure iron is very soft and stretches easily when hot. Okay. Alloy is a very good method of improving the properties of a metal. Why we are using the alloys? Because of improving the properties of the metals. We can get the desired properties by this method. For suppose, pure iron is there. Pure iron is a very soft. Okay. It is a very soft. That's why it is never used in its pure state. Pure iron is a very soft, that's why we cannot use that iron in pure state. This is because pure iron is very soft and stretches easily when hot. When it is hot, it is very soft and stretches. Okay, then what we can do, which iron we are using in the general purpose in the construction of buildings and any bridges, any iron used works. If it is mixed with a small amount of carbon, that is a 0.005. okay, if it is mixed with a small amount of carbon, about 0.05%, it becomes hard and strong. When iron is mixed with nickel and chromium, we can get the stainless steel, which is hard and does not rust. Okay, here pure iron is a very soft and stretches. Okay, that's why we did not use the pure iron. Then how can we get the it is a strong? We can add some amount of carbon. How much amount of carbon? That is a 0.05%. Okay, 0.05% of carbon we can add into the pure iron, then it will be very strong. How much carbon we are adding? 0.05% of carbon. Then it will be very strong, become hard and strong. Okay, when iron is mixed with nickel, okay, iron is mixed with nickel, iron plus nickel, it will be stainless, it will be give the, we can get the stainless steel. Okay, iron is mixed with nickel and chromium, iron Fe, nickel and chromium, these three are, when we are mixed, we can get the stainless steel. This is a composition of stainless steel. In the stainless steel, which metals are there, which elements are there? Iron, nickel, chromium, these are the three. When we are mixing the iron, nickel, chromium, we can get the stainless steel, which is hard and does not rust. That alloys are does not rust, and thus if iron is mixed with some other substances, its properties will be changed. Pure iron properties and alloys properties, if iron is mixed with some other substances, means its properties will be changed. In fact, the properties of any metal can be changed if it is mixed with some other substance. Not only iron, if the properties of any metal can be changed if it is mixed with some other substance. If we mixed any metal with other substances, their properties will be changed. The substance added may be a metal or a non-metal. The substance may be that is a metal or non-metal we can add. An alloy is a, how can we define the alloy? Alloy is a homogeneous mixture of two or more than two metals or a metal and non-metal. How can you define the alloy? Alloy is a homogeneous mixture of two or more than two metals or a metal and non-metal. Not only metals, maybe metal and non-metal also possible. Okay, it is a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture of two or more than two metals or more than two non-metals also possible. Okay, it is prepared by first melting the primary metal and then dissolving the other elements in it in definite proportions. It is then cooled at room temperature. Okay, how can we prepare this alloys? First we have to take the one metal. Okay, it is prepared by first melting the primary metal. We have to take the one primary metal, and we can melting the primary metal and then dissolving the other elements in it in definite proportions. For suppose, if any other element, other metal or any other non-metal is there, means first we have to take the first primary metal and melt that primary metal and dissolving the other elements in it a definite proportions. It is then cooled at a room temperature. okay, after dissolving the another metal, we can cool another metal or non-metal, we can cool at a room temperature, then we can get the alloy. Okay, first it is prepared by melting the primary metal and then dissolving the other elements in it in a definite proportions. Then it is cooled into the room temperature, then we can get the alloys.